As a very simple test for the Fusion 360 CAD and CAM combination, I made this very simple little tray out of cherry wood. It's supposed to be used for serving a dessert, so you have the three porcelain cups that each fits into a little pocket. So basically I have three pockets and then an outer pocket just to make it nice, and then I have also used the router to make a nice bevel here, but that was not done on the CNC. So I'll show how I did it in Fusion and also how it came out on the machine. So inside Fusion 360 I will make the drawing of the tray. I will start with a sketch. I'll put it on the XY plane. I will start with a rectangle, just hit R, go to the center, hit it like that, and I will dimension it using D. (300 × 100 mm). Here we have it. Then I will make an inner rectangle and I just use the snap functions here, so it actually has the right size now, like that. And then I will make some temporary lines or construction lines to position the three holes. I hit L, go to the center here, which is marked by the triangle, like that. And then I will do the same going the other way around, triangle here, so this is the middle hole. I'll then make those into construction lines, so I'll select this one and I'll select this one using the shift key. So now they're constructions line. Then I can use C. I could use C, but it doesn't work. I can then make a circle. Go here, I'll put it up here, and it's gonna be 72 mm. Like that. And then I will make two more construction lines. I'll just put them in arbitrary place from here to here, and another one over here. And then I will use the dimension tool to put the distance right. It's going to be 52 mm, and the same in the other end here, from this to this. 52 mm, like that. And then I will hit escape. I'll select the two lines I'll use as construction line, this one and this one, and I'll make them into construction line. Then I will hit the C, and it doesn't work for some strange reason. Now I have it here like that, 72 mm. And the last one, so here we have the sketch. The last thing I want to do is just to make a radius on this one. Radius of the bit, so I say 6. Okay, so that's the end of that. So stop sketch. We are back in a 3D mode, and since my plate will be 10 millimeter high and I want this to be 2 mm and this another 2, I'll just take it sequentially doing this extrusion here. So I'll hit E for extrusion, and I'll start with the 3 here. And I will then lift those 6 mm And now it turns off the sketch. You just need to go back and turn it on again to continue the extrusion, because then the next one I will be extruding is this one, and I'll then extrude that 8 millimeter. And here again, it's important to see that now it goes to join. It was before it was a new body, and this time I want to use join because this is one part. So you have to be aware of this operation. It changes on what the program believes you want to do, but you need to be aware of what you want. So now we have that one and it's joined, so we still only have one body here. And then the final extrusion is this one, and then we want to lift that 10 millimeters, and again it says join, which is okay for now. And here we have the whole tray. And then on the other side, just click the sketch off, I want to make a bevel or chamfer on the bottom side here. So I will select my edges, and here I have selected all four bottom edges, and I'll make the chamfer 5 millimeters, so like this. Hit OK, and then basically now I have my finished part ready to define the cam operations. So to make the cam operations, you will go to the cam part of the program. What we need to do is to position the orientation, and I would like to use this corner as my zero, so the top corner of my workpiece. So we do like that. So now it's oriented with Z up and Y and X. Defining the stock, I basically just say that the stock is what I have, so like that. And that's all I need to do, because I will be using pre-cut material that has the exact size that I want. I'll not do an outside profile. The setup, the next thing is to define the pockets, and I'll just go and ask for a 2D pocket. And the first thing we need to do is select a bit. I will use a 6 millimeter flat end mill like this one. I'm not caring too much which one I take. Speeds and feeds, I'll leave that open. Geometry, I'll go and select this one like that. And then the heights are okay. The passes, we'll just do it in one go, so I think we should be good to just say okay. And here we have the path. Then next is to create the pocket for the three holes there. So we'll make a 2D pocket again. Same tool, geometry, this one, and this one. And the rest will stay the same, so it's okay. We have the code here. And then if we shift and click that one, then we have all the code, and we can just simulate how it works. We have the stock on, so we can see it, and we simply just click go, increase the speed a little. So this is the first level, the first 2 millimeters taken off, and then it goes down and makes the bigger hole. And that is essentially all we need to do. So let's go and do it on the machine. Oh, made this jig or whatever with four brackets, so my piece of material just fits real snug here, and then I can mill it and then put in a new one.